Hey guys, so today we're looking at converting from base 10 to any other base. All right, so to our first problem here, we got 10, 17 and base 10. We're going to convert that to base 2. Now, when you're converting to bases, it's all about the importance of the place value. What I mean by that, in base 10, you will have our 1, 10, 100, 1,000, meaning to be multiples of. That's the same thing that we have to do when we convert into another base. So we're going to look to the base 2. We're going to have our first entity, which is our 1, and then a multiple of 2, that will be 2. Then that's 4. That's 8. That is 60. Now, what this does is that this tells me that 17, and I'm going to convert to the base 10, we're going to have 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 digits. So now that we have all the place values, what we're going to do, we're going to see how many of those place values that we can get out of that number. Now, because we're dealing with base 2, we know that we can only use numbers smaller than 2, 1s and 0s. For base 10, we go from any number from 9 to 0. So how many 16 can I get out of 17? I can get 1. Now, when I take away 16, from 17, I'm left back with 1 unit. So, how many 8s? Can I get a 1? Well, you can. So, you put a 0 there. How many 4s? 0. How many 2s? 0s. And I can get 1, 1 from 1. So, 17 in base, and in base 2 is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. That difficult, right? Let's look at another problem. So let's say that we have this problem, 36. In base 10, we're going to convert to base 5. Just like we did in our previous exercise, we're going to list the place values of base 10. So in base 10, base 5, sorry, we will have our 1s. We have our 5s. We have our 25s. And then we have 125. Oops, 125. Now, because 125 has exceeded the size of the number, then we know that we'll be using that place value here. This 125, we don't need this. So we can set 36 in base, and base 5 is going to have been 3 entities. Now, I mean, 25 can I have a 26? 36, we already have the 1 here. So we're going to say 36. Minus 25, bearing in mind that for base 5, we can use numbers from 4 go down to 0. So 6, 5 from 6, we have 1. And 2 from 3, we have 1. So we have up to 11. Now, how many 5s can I get? Can I get it out of 11? 2. So, and we know that 5 times 2, that's 10. Meaning that we have a remainder of 1. And then we get 1, 1 out of that. So 36 in base 10 is 121. That's our answer in base 10. Pretty cool, huh? Now, what about 50 to base 8? 50 to base 8. So for base 8, we have our 1s. We have our 8s. And 8s are 64. Now, because this 64 is greater than our number, we know that we're not going to use this 64. So 15 base 8 is going to have two numbers. For base 8, remember, we can use numbers from 7 go down. So how many 8s can I get out of 50? We can get 6. So we know that 8 6 are 48. So we have 50. Minus 48, that remains the 2. And we can get 2 ones out of 2. So 15 base 8.